Excellent. Let's get started.
One question you probably ask yourself many times in the past is how long should your exercise sessions last?
It can't be stopped.
Is there really a time for your workouts that you don't want to exceed? Surely you've heard some people say that exercising for more than 45 minutes, or an hour, or longer, will actually have a negative effect on your hormones, and will, in the long run, do more harm than good, and obviously also limit your progress. Another group says that the more time you dedicate to workouts, the faster you'll get results. So who, out of these groups, is actually right?
No, Mr. When the meeting was adjourned, the vote was 9-9.
Well, in this video, we are gonna touch on all those points in a simple way. We will give some personal suggestions, and we will review exactly what scientific research has to say on the topic. But before we get started on that, please consider subscribing to our channel and hitting the bell notification icon to stay more up to date. So, let's start with the very common belief that you should never exceed 1 hour workouts, and preferably even keep your workouts below 45 minutes. This idea is based mainly on what happens to your hormones like testosterone, growth hormone, and cortisol while you do your workouts. When you start exercising, your body will respond by naturally increasing testosterone levels. And the theory is that this impulse is supposed to help improve our performance, help us build muscle to a greater extent, and, at the same time, help us burn more fat. So, the idea is that after 45 minutes, your cortisol levels will begin to increase, while your testosterone levels will begin to decrease, which puts your body in a catabolic mode. What does that mean? Well, that means it's more likely to break down muscle tissue for energy and store more body fat instead. Therefore, it doesn't really make a lot of sense to exercise beyond the 45-minute mark, which would be a waste of time and even worse, make you lose all your hard work at the gym. But how true is all of that in actuality? Let us find out.
What are we waiting for? Take this!
So, among the studies that were done on this topic, there is a small one in 2001 that involved a rather small sample size of 16 men. The researchers took these men and divided them into two groups. The first group trained only their arms over 9 weeks. The other group trained their arms in the same way, but they also included 8 sets of legs exercising at the end of their workout to stimulate the release of more testosterone and growth hormone. Indeed, after each workout, blood tests showed that a group that also trained their legs experienced higher peaks in testosterone and growth hormone levels. And at the end of the 9 weeks, the group that worked both arms and legs increased their strength by a whopping 37%, while the group that only worked their arms and didn't do leg training increased their strength only by 9%. However, did this study actually show that it is better to maintain a training below 45 minutes, and thus stay under the effect of elevated testosterone and growth hormone? The reality is, this particular study was flawed. The participants in the group of arms and legs began between 20 and 25% weaker than the participants which only worked out their arms, being beginners, and having the additional advantage of growing more easily than those that were already more developed. Therefore, the test was finally inconclusive.
Now you pissed me off.
But, fortunately, the story doesn't end here. Another study with 12 men divided them once again into two groups. And once again, one group only worked arms, and the other worked arms and legs. The group that worked both sides had an increase in both testosterone and growth hormone, compared to the one that worked only on their arms. Nevertheless, it was a small number of subjects, and the results were once again inconclusive. Other researchers went further, with another study of 56 subjects. Here, they showed that there is a change in growth hormone and testosterone, but with very little relation to the growth of muscle or the increase in strength. There were more studies carried out in this manner, with somewhat conflicting results once again. The research definitely does conclude that there is no evidence to suggest that exercise, If it induces these hormones, testosterone and cortisol, actually leads to more muscle gain. But we still have to find out if the 45 minutes, or 1 hour, or 90 minutes of training would actually have a negative impact on the outcome. So, the decrease in testosterone and the increase in cortisol at the 45-minute mark of exercising is not a factor that should worry us too much in our results. So, better focus on other factors. So, what should we learn from this? Please, do not focus on just spending time at the gym. Doing the exercises properly is more important than the time spent. So, it should definitely be obvious that you cannot take long breaks, or wasting your time talking with your friends or taking selfies at the gym. Focus on doing the right exercises. Take your correct resting time as well, whether it is 1 minute or 3 minutes, depending on what you're doing. Never think about the total time you spend at the gym. That is definitely not a determining factor. There are, however, 4 other determining factors to definitely take into account when you are at the gym. These are frequency, intensity, sets, and repetitions. These are main factors that give volume and prove to increase muscle and give you better results. A clear example is to work your chest 2 times a week instead of once a week, and this will lead you to better results. Increasing the weight you use week after week would also lead you to better results. The increase in sets and repetitions can also lead you to faster results. So, what do we learn here? Please, focus on these factors. They are way more important than getting out of your routine at the 45-minute mark just to avoid the rise of cortisol. Do not be silly looking for quick exits.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Work on those 4 factors and, you guessed it, you will be led to better results. I hope you like this video on Fit Fat Factor, and remember to subscribe to receive more videos and click the bell notification icon. We also appreciate constructive comments down below. Have a healthy day and see you in the next video.